In this video I'm going to show you how to use a RainStorm tool Photoshop action. So I'm going to use this photo here. I'm going to play the action here and customize the effect, and this is what I'm going to create. Okay. So as you can see, the action creates this storm texture in the background, the rain, rocks and so on. So I got a few more examples of the photos that I created using this action. So from this photo I created this. From this, created this. And from this, this. Okay, so I'm going to close these windows now. So this is the photo that I'm going to use. So first what you need to check when you open up your photo is that your photo is a background layer, so it must be called a background and have this lock icon here. So if it's something like this or anything else, you just go to layer, new, and choose background from layer. Okay, so that will make your layer a background layer. Also you should check the image mode. It should be RGB color mode, 8-bit Canon, and check the image size. So resolution should be 300, and you should have at least 1500 wide or height. Okay. So I'm just gonna leave these settings like this, and now I'm going to load the action. So to load the action, go to Window, Actions, click on this little arrow here, Load Actions, and just choose the action that came in download. Okay. So here it is. So here we got the RainStorm and the HDR effect. So now what you gotta do is to make a new layer, double click there, and just name it brush. And it's very important to, all letters must be lowercase, so otherwise the action won't work. Okay, and then just grab a brush tool and choose any color. Color is not important, and just brush over your photo. So I have already done this before, so I'm just gonna open my PSD. Okay, so when you finish with brushing, as you can see, you don't have to be too precise. That's great. And when you finish with brushing, you just have to play the action. First we're gonna play the RainStorm 2. Okay, so I'm gonna pause the video here, and I'm gonna get back when the action is finished to show you how can you customize the effect. Okay. Okay, the action has just stopped, so first I will close the action panel. And you will see that when the action is finished that all folders are open. And to easily get around, what we're going to do, we're going to close all the folders. And how to easily do that is to hold Ctrl-Alt button for PC or Command-Alt for Mac, and just click on the little arrow here. And you'll see that all folders will be closed. So now, let's see what we got here. These are the rain hits. So these are actually these small rain splashes there, and when you open it, you see that it's layered, so you can just remove some of the splashes by hiding the layer or brushing black into the mask, or select the main group and just take a black color for foreground and just brush over the place you want to remove the splashes. See, you can get them back easily by brushing white. Okay. And what you can also do, you can duplicate some of these layers or the whole group, and create more splashes just in seconds. Okay, so when you duplicate it, then you can you must select the group here, and then just move the splashes as you like. Okay. So this is the front rain group, and this is actually rain. As name says, front is going in front of our photo, and we got also the background rain. Okay, we're gonna see later. So the background layer is not going over your photo. So when you open the front rain group, we got two layers. Okay, so you can control the deploy of the rain with these layers. So if you want to be more densely deployed, turn on both layers, and you can also duplicate one of these layers on both and then move the rain, and you're gonna get more rain, raindrops. Okay. What you can also do, you can turn on these layers called increase density, and now remove this cursor, you can control the density of the rain. Okay. So it's gonna look like this. And what you can also do, you can remove any drop that you like. Just set foreground color to black, just a soft brush, and make sure that the layer mask is selected here. And I just brush when you want to remove the drops. Okay. If you can't remove some of the drops, that means that drop is a background rain, so I'm gonna show you the group later. Okay. That's it. So let's see what we got next. These are the rocks. So we got the smaller rocks and we got the large rocks here. And these rocks are fully layered and they are all fully customizable. So you can just transform them however you want. Okay, so you can rotate the rocks, you can scale the rocks, and or you can also remove any of the rocks that you didn't like by hiding the layer, or just brushing the black into its layer mask. So select the layer mask, except for the color for black, and just brush over that rock that you want to remove. And now I have selected the layer mask of the first rocks layer, so when I brush black, I only remove the rocks that are on this layer. If you want to remove any of the rocks, then select this main layer mask, and then brush with black color, and just remove any rock that you want. That's nice. What you can also do is you can duplicate any of these rocks layer or the whole group, and then just get more rocks actually in seconds, and just make sure to select the folder, and as you can see, if you create more rocks that you can again transform by rotate, duplicate, blurring, scaling, or anything else. Okay. And these are the large rocks, so you can customize them in the same way as these rocks here. So you can also duplicate them, move them, rotate them, and so on. And we're just going to leave them like this. Okay, so what we got here is your photo. And it's got this layer mask here. So this layer mask, if you disable it, you'll see that the edges will become more sharper. So this is just a layer mask is softening the edges here. So your photo is better suited with the texture. And this is the background rain. So as you can see, it's also layered. And as I said, this rain is not going over your photo, and it's just in the background, as its name says. And you can also duplicate any of these layers and move them to create more raindrops. You can simply hide the rain if you don't like it. Okay, so you can hide also these rain or hide the rocks. So we got really a lot of options here, and this is the background texture. Okay, so you can also play with the opacities of these three layers here. Okay. So now here we got the adjustments. So there are the brightness. When you double click here, you can move these two cursors here to control the brightness. Like this. This is over here. Okay. And this is the black and white effect. So for your photo, if you don't want to be black and white, just hide this layer. I'm going to leave it black and white. And this is the contrast. You can control the contrast by moving this cursor here. Okay. And, leave it like this. And this is the brush layer. The brush layer that we made in the beginning of the video. This layer, I like this brush layer here because the action is made so every time you run the action you're going to get a different result even if you use the same brush area. So if you just remove these two groups and play the action again, you're going to actually get unique results. These rocks will have a different deployed and they have different form. It's the same about the background texture and the rain. So when you finish with customizing the effect, we just need to play the ADR action. Okay. So I will play the action now. Pause the video here and get back when the action is finished. Okay, the action has just stopped, so I'll close the action now. And let's see what we got here. So this is the HDR effect. And when you open the folder, you're gonna see there are all the layers here, but what you gotta actually do here is, you got another black here. Okay, gradient and adjustment layer. And this is the soft edge layer, so it's giving the soft edge the photo. And what you actually have, I should change here only is the opacity of the base HDR. Okay, so this is actually the HDR effect. And so by moving this cursor here, you will control the HDR. Okay, so as you can see, just set the amount that you like. I can set to like this. Actually, as it was, and I'm pretty much happy with the effect. So that's it. I hope you understood everything. If you still need any help with the action, feel free to contact me anytime via my Envato profile page. And thanks for watching. Bye.